Yo, 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 let's get the business.
Yo, 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 let's get the business. I got DJ Juiceman in the building, man.
What's happening?
What's going on with you, man?
Chilling, bro.
He's a mixtape monster. Extra mixtape monster. And, you know, he can get the business with you, whatever you want. You want your mixtape slots? What else you do, man?
Mixtape uploads.
Mixtape uploads.
Single uploads.
Single uploads.
Gonna start the Spotify playlist soon.
Yeah. The Mixtape Maniac, y'all.
Whatever you need.
DJ Juiceman. And he came to kick it with me, man. So let's get the business, man. You know, you done seen what goes on up here. You know, I had to get you up here.
It's been a minute. Yeah. A little scheduling issues. We finally got to going.
Yo, that's all good, man. As long as it happened, that's normal. You know, I work with everybody. But yeah, let's get the business, man. So before we get into the Mixtape Maniac stuff, because you already know that's what you're known for. That's what I know you for.
Mm-hmm.
But we're going to start a little slight on a little bit about your upbringing.
Okay.
So just tell the people a little bit about, like, you know, how you came up and was you always into music or things like that?
Yeah. I'm originally from Bardstown, Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I grew up, you know, my mom and my dad. I have a sister. I've been a fan of rap music since I was like 8, 9 years old.
Word.
I remember like when I was in like 4th grade, I used to like rap Carter, the Carter lyrics on my bed.
Yeah, the Carter, yeah. That went hard though. That mixtape was, everybody's listening to that. Or no, the album.
Yeah.
Carter, yeah. That's funny though. So yeah, I figured you always been into music. For somebody that surrounds yourself around music and everybody that do music so much as you, I already knew you was into it probably for a long time, you know what I mean? And I'm telling you, man, you could tell you from that era, you know what I mean? We from the mixtape era, basically. So so you always had the urge to be a mix DJ? Or when did that first start out for you?
I originally started with the blog.
And, so you started vlogging at first?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, called Got the Juice KY to promote Kentucky artists.
Because,
you know, I've known a lot of Kentucky artists since I was like 15, 16.
You're putting that work in, I'm telling you. He's worked with a lot of different artists from around here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so started with that, and it, you know, it built a buzz gradually.
Mm-hmm.
And I would post artist songs on my SoundCloud that I made.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that you know, started to gain popularity, and I would do interviews and stuff on the blog as well.
Right.
And I eventually, I came out with 2 mixtapes, Got the Juice Volume 1 and Got the Juice Volume 2. And you were actually on Got the Juice Volume 2.
I was on it? Where? Yeah. Got the Juice. I remember the title, Got the Juice Volume 2. Okay.
Yep.
And no time was joined.
I think it was one of the songs with you and your brother, Seven Child.
Hard. Probably me and Seven. Yep. Yeah. But, man, you had a gang of artists on those tapes.
A lot.
That's why I like getting on them, because I knew, like, you know, everybody was going to tune in and listen to it.
Mm-hmm.
You had the right interest that was flooded toward the tapes. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, with the various artists and artists that I haven't heard of that I was just now locking in on. So
I think that second one had like 50 songs on it. It was a little too much.
A little different name.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I should have done a little less, you know, save for the volume 3, but I mean, I just want everybody that wanted to be a part of it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it was beautiful how you put that together, man. You just ended up becoming that one. Everybody's like, man, you got, like, you had to get one through you. Like, you got to get a tape through Juiceman. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Get it hosted and everything. Got your plugins flying in and everything. And the drops, you know what I mean?
I got a lot of drops.
Yeah. So how'd you come up with the name Juiceman?
It originally stemmed from the name of the blog. Like, people, you know, called me Juice, and there was this old dude I work with. He found out about it. He started calling me Juice Man.
Call you Juice. That's cool.
Yeah. So that's
Juice.
You know, it kind of stuck.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, I'm gonna go by DJ Juice Man.
Word. So kind of just therapeutic. It just came. You know, what I mean? Just naturally a little bit. That's hard, man. So your biggest inspirations in life, like, even if it don't have nothing to do with music, like, basically, like, who's somebody that inspired you, or somebody that dropped gems on you, or No, mainly not the gyms yet, but basically somebody that inspired you, somebody that you looked at or maybe mirrored or you just looked up to coming up.
Like you said, we came from the mixtape era. So
Definitely.
DJ Drama, he's an inspiration.
We're gonna get into him later.
Big Bigga Rankin, DJ Scream, Traps and Trunks, which I actually did a project with him.
Traps and Trunks is hard. DJ Green Lantern? Remember
I
him?
yes, he was hard.
Green Lantern was hard.
Let's see, other inspirations.
Probably a bunch of them like me. You just got them all scattered everywhere.
But I'm trying to think, like mostly music. But Rob Dyrdek, he's actually, one of my inspirations as well. That's the
Rob Dyrdek, yeah.
because he's so business minded. Like if you listen to what he says,
Okay.
like you can really learn some shit.
Okay. I like business mind, an entrepreneur type of mind. Yeah, I'm into things like that. So that's hard, man. And I knew you had a bunch of inspiration. You can just go on and on with them. This is crazy. So the Spinrilla mixtape run though. That's what was crazy with you. That's and I'm not gonna hold you. It was a long run because like every time I looked up, it was just like you was posting another tape and you was pumping another tape and you was putting that work in.
I was dropping like 3, 4 a month.
Man. That's what it was about, man. So, and I know you made some cake, you know what I mean? Because
A lot.
you got to make sure the bag was right, to go through you. But yeah, it was dope, man. It was just a nice centerpiece to have for the culture, man. It was a nice representation because we don't have a lot of, especially when we like then, it wasn't a lot of hip hop going on, a lot of for the culture going on, right? Almost you had to create it sometimes. You know what I mean? And he's one of them people that created that world for us. So that's dope.
Kentucky has a lot of talent.
Yeah.
A lot of artists are overlooked.
Definitely. You think about ever doing the slots again? Coming up, opening up slots or dropping tapes again?
I actually had some projects in the works that have been discussed.
Couple
We just
projects?
yeah. It's just I gotta get back in that mode.
Right. Get in the vibe, get in the mood for it.
And just get
Yeah.
everything, back situated.
I feel that.
Get my mindset back right.
Right. Different things tackle you. You got to handle that first, and then it'll be there. Yeah. So, who did the graphic designs for the project? Because you always had those real nice and colorful too. You had the juice flowing on them and all that.
My main graphic designer goes by Sick Empire.
Okay. Shout out to them, man. Yo.
Crazy turnaround time. Like same, like same, like within an hour.
Yeah.
I got some shit back in like 30 minutes
That's
before.
hard, and that's important too. Especially when when you got to put it on the different streaming platforms and stuff. You gotta make sure it's right.
He always got them together. Flex and Designs, that was another graphic artist I worked with.
Nice. I'm into graphics. Shout out to them, man.
It was that's probably the main two.
That's
Cause
hard.
just because there's I like consistency,
I like that.
building relationships.
Yes,
So,
consistency is the key, and it's all about the relationships for real.
because networking can get you indoors that money can't.
Man, you hear this? These are factuals right here. So, yeah, moving forward with this, the Hustleholics merch too. I was gonna ask you about that because you was doing the shirts and all that. So, tell me about the vision behind that a little bit, and how'd you come about doing that?
I'd always wanted to start a clothing brand, and me and my homie DJ Bieski out in North Carolina, we have this mixtape series called Hustleholics. And if you know me, I'm all about hustling.
Get some grind
Any
on.
way I can get some, almost any way I can get some money, I'm gonna get it.
Yeah, about your
So
Grizzly.
yeah,
Every
so
as long as I've known you, you've always been on the bag.
so. You know, that we had that mixtape title, and I was like, man, that'd be perfect.
It's dope.
Because I mean, it symbolizes
A lot.
what really what it's all about.
Yeah, the struggle, the ups and downs, the rags, the riches. That's what I love most. Like, man, what I'm really attached to when it comes to music is that hustle story.
Because if you ain't got hustle, what you got?
Yeah, man, that's what I come from, and that's what I relate to. That's what I hear most clearly. You know what I mean? And that's what a lot of my music was. It was based off that grit. So,
I like that real music. You Smoketown Nave,
Yeah, definitely. Shout out Nave.
Seventh child. And
Seven.
Y'all got reality rap.
Facts. Most definitely. So yeah, I always like that title, Hustleholics, just talking to you. Yeah. So what was one tape that you put together that, like, at the end of putting it together, you was like, yo, this is a classic. This is an absolute flamer.
There's a lot of them. Are we talking various artists or, like, you know, artist tapes?
Ooh, I could have mixed it up like that. I could have did various artists and an artist tape. But however you want to answer it, as long as you're comfortable, you know, answering it, however you want to do it.
I'd say...
I was curious.
Probably that Juice Overload 4.
Yeah.
Which on that tape, I actually had an artist in Atlanta host it, and he recorded an intro specifically for that tape. I thought that was real.
That's
cool.
Dope. That was thoughtful of him.
Yeah.
Too, man.
So I like that. Let's see, Juice Overload 4.
It got the juices hard too.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was nice.
The Probably that first Get Rich or Die Dripping that I did.
Yeah, I remember that title too.
I was on the cover of that one just because I wanted to throw myself.
Yeah, you'd be chilled and calm on the cover too, man.
Yeah. As far as artist projects, like that, Still Surviving too.
Man, Seven.
Crazy.
Seven with bananas on that.
We actually got some shit coming eventually as well.
It's hard. Yes, let's get the business.
Me and you we got that Banksy project.
The Banksy project. I never even, yeah, okay. Yeah, 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 yeah.
We actually came out with that. I don't remember exactly
what
how.
What year was that?
That was 2017, 18, something
probably,
like that.
Probably was, yeah. Cause I did the graphics for it myself.
Yeah, it came out, it was in my memories. Mm-hmm. A few days ago, in like 2018.
That's hard, man. Salute to that. The Banksy project. That's me.
We got...
So there's a bunch of them.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah.
Real Deal Reloaded.
Mm-hmm.
My bro, Real Deal Lock.
Plus, there's always just new artists popping up. I remember you just dropping them tapes, and I was like, who is that? Who is that? It was always just the new artist, like, whoa. You was pumping them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Consistency, definitely.
Bootstrap Music, the first one.
Okay.
That actually got me recognized by Soulja Boy.
That's hard. Shout out to Soulja.
Yeah, he followed me.
Did
on Instagram, yeah.
That's nice, man. It's always good to get that recognition.
Yeah. Yeah, it was dope.
And that don't surprise me, though, because like I said, the consistency was there, man. You was putting it in.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of artists that I listened to growing up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I eventually ended up having relationships with them.
Like, yeah.
It's crazy how
that's
that
how
works.
It happens. That was one of my questions, actually, is do you still have relationships with artists that, you know, you did business with or that you dropped music with and stuff like that?
Yeah, like, some artists, like, they're just like family to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I, you know, still talk to them every month, every, you know, not every week, but, like, we're still close.
Right. It's a cool relationship.
Yeah.
That's hard. So I got to get into it, and this is a petty question. I'm sure you know what's coming because you watch my episodes. iPhone or Android?
iPhone. I tried to go to Android a few months ago. Dog, it lasted like 2 months. I couldn't do it.
Didn't last long.
Couldn't do it.
Yeah, man. Shout out. You know, it's got to be Team iPhone all day. I got the Mac, you know. Got the iPhone. Yeah.
That's what I need to get me is a Mac.
Word. Yeah, it works for me. You know what I mean? But yeah, Team iPhone. Let's get the business. okay, so I'm going to get into, like, you know, I'm going to ask you, like, would you rather prefer this or that or him or her?
Okay.
Or this or that. You know what I mean? So the first one I got for you, I got a DJ Drama or DJ Clue?
I'm going to say Drama.
DJ Drama?
Yeah.
Word. Shout out to DJ Drama. Yeah. Word. Is there a specific reason behind it or?
That's one of the main people I think of when I think of mixtapes.
Man, his voice too, man. Like, yeah, he got a signature mixtape voice. Like, when he does his intros, that's what I like about him, man.
I've actually been to his studio when I went to Atlanta.
Word.
That shit was hard.
I bet that was nasty. I bet that was nice. Yeah. Yeah. That was a nice experience there. And I know he got the in cahoots with Jack Harlow and all that type of stuff. So yeah, man. So here's the next one. I got Trina or Cardi B?
Trina.
Word. Is that don't hold, I'm not gonna hold you. Is there a specific reason behind that?
Cardi's too ratchet.
Word?
Yeah.
I mean,
plus Trina's the original. I mean,
okay. However you want to answer the question, that's cool.
But hold on, are we talking about Trina and her prime?
Well, however you want, however you want to answer your own version, your own
currently Cardi B, but Trina and her prime.
Okay,
killing Cardi.
So you're still rolling with Trina though.
Yeah.
Okay.
They Trina, both. Trina right now.
I know what you mean.
Yeah.
It's like a tricky question, kind of. So here we go. Rolling with this. We got Trap or Die, Young Jeezy, or we got Tucci, Drop 3, Lil Wayne.
That's a hard one.
Since you're the mixtape maniac, you know what I mean? I had to ask you that.
I'm
going
to go with Wayne, just because, you know, that's one of my favorite artists.
Word.
That's actually, you know, one of my favorite mixtapes he's done.
Yeah. He was going nuts on those.
But that Trap or Die, though, that's crazy, too.
Man,
crazy too.
That was hard. Some people forget about that one, so I had to throw it in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Both of them's hard. But, yeah, that drought, yeah. And the notes. Okay, we'll go get into something different. But, yeah, I almost said it. But, so do you feel like music can alter moods?
Oh, yeah.
And like, vibes and energies and stuff like that?
Yeah. Are you ready? For sure.
Okay.
Because whenever I'm feeling down,
yeah,
you know, I'll put on some music to uplift me.
Definitely.
Whenever I'm feeling mad, I might put on some metal or some shit just to
word.
Just, you know, whatever
one time.
Like whatever mood I'm in, that's the type of music I'll be listening to at that time.
Most definitely. So basically, that it talks your mood, mm-hmm. It speaks your mood. Yeah, that's a question that I ask sometimes. Okay, I got another one for you. Fab or Jadakiss?
We'll go with Fab.
Word. I don't know why I had a feeling you was gonna roll with Fab, but yeah, I can't argue. Okay, so is there a specific reason behind that one?
Not necessarily. I just know more of Fabulous's music.
Okay,
than
that's a good reason.
Than Kiss.
What? Yeah, so you can't go over.
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely. Hunger Games or The Walking Dead?
I'll go with Hunger Games.
I like that. I like that answer. I haven't seen enough of The Walking Dead.
Yeah, same. Like I read some of the comics.
Mm-hmm.
But I haven't really watched The Walking Dead.
Also, it's originally a comic?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Walking Dead is like I see other people watching it, but I never really had
that. I guess it seems like it'd be real good, but I don't know. I just haven't gotten the chance to watch it.
Word. Okay. Let's get to business, though. Pimp C or Lil Boosie?
I'm going to go with Pimp C.
Word. Yeah. I can't argue that.
I mean, I love Boosie, but Pimp C, come on.
Church, happened now. Yeah. The pimp, man. So let me ask you this. How do you feel the old school DJing game compares to like, you know, like the scratch and spin and all that compared to the new technology game of DJing?
Really, I think like the technology, it just made it a whole lot easier for for more DJs to, you know, access it.
Man, 100%.
But that old school, you know, actually having to, you know, change the vinyls and shit.
The vinyl scratch.
That's dope.
Yeah, that is hard. It's like, that's like the original essence of the hip-hop DJ inside of it, yeah. But yeah, it made it, you're right, it just made it more easily accessible.
Like me personally, I would much rather do it the old school way. Just, I mean, I've never done it, but just to see if I can do it.
Okay, I see what you're saying, because you never really felt that side.
Yeah.
That's an interesting way to put it. Yeah. Huh. So, moving forward with this, so how has the new streaming era affected the career of DJ, you think? Think there's a lot more DJs now?
Me, personally, I feel like it's affected it a lot, like, because our services aren't as needed as they used to be.
Word.
because a lot of mixtape sites, they actually offer incentives to use them.
Most definitely.
Like a lot of mixtapes, they started a program sometime last year where they'll pay, you know, pay you for your streams compared to like Spotify, Apple Music.
Oh, okay. Wow. Yeah. I bet that did change the game a lot.
Yeah.
So the demand for the service is a little bit.
Yeah, I feel like it kind of screwed us, but you know, it is what it is. Yeah.
You adjust pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So how do you feel about this dives into this next joint? How you feel about AI? You know, like artificial intelligence.
It's kind of scary for real. Yeah, like it's
next level.
Like we got self-driving cars now. Like that shit's crazy.
Yeah. Like, I mean, there's everything out there.
Yeah, like
it's happening fast too.
Yeah, like I feel like the whole world's gonna be, you know, like robots. Like it's gonna take over the world eventually. I feel like
that's what it's looking like.
But hey, it is what it is.
Yeah, better adjust fast.
Yeah,
it just happens so fast. There's always something new popping up on you every day. It's like
I watched a video the other day. They were talking about chips. Like, they were developing chips that you can put in your brain.
Elon Musk and them?
Yeah, yeah.
they got to chill.
For real.
They got to relax with that.
But, like, they were talking about, like, you know, if you lost feeling in one of your limbs, the chip could help you regain feeling. Yeah.
I seen Obama and them talking about that. Like, it was, like, 2012.
Yeah, it's a really cool concept, but it's kind of weird at the same time.
There's a lot of power behind that. If it does, I mean, like, that's interesting.
Would you get a chip?
No.
Yeah, same.
I don't feel comfortable at all. Nobody puts.
No.
I don't even like getting my blood drawn.
No, when dog, I go to the hospital. Hate that shit.
I'm like, yo.
That's why I don't go.
Yeah. And I'm like, can y'all not do it right here? Yeah. like I'm, you know what I'm saying? Like, do it right here or something.
Yeah, like, you know, just let me look away. I ain't trying to. Like, I hate needles. I hate needles so much.
They had this young girl that I don't know if she was, like, I guess she was a new worker and she went to draw my blood. She was all shaky and stuff. Like, she didn't know what I was doing. I was like, yo.
Yeah, they don't even know what they're doing. They blow your shit out real
quick. Yeah, I was like, yo, she got the needle all stuck in there. Like, yo, what's going on? Until, like, an older nurse came over there and done it. But that's crazy.
That's what
AI is crazy, though.
Yeah.
Artificial intelligence is getting nuts, bro. Like, so moving forward with this, who you picking between these two? I got Jelly Roll or Jack Harlow.
Jelly Roll.
Word.
Yeah, I've been hip to Jelly Roll since like 2008, 2009.
Yeah. So definitely, I remember him being at Tailgaters with us. Like,
yeah,
a grip ago. Yeah.
Yeah, he's progressed. He's transformed a lot. Like, and you know, I'm just seeing him blow up, going from, you know,
from Tailgater days,
to now, like,
yeah,
that's awesome.
I think it was like him and Haystack the night.
Yeah,
I was there, but yeah, the transformation is wild. Yeah, shout out to Jelly Roll, man. So Jelly Roll, you probably relate to his music pretty much.
Yeah, right?
Yeah,
that's actually, you know, one of the artists that I listen to a lot whenever I'm going through some shit.
Word, most definitely. So, DJ Screw or Funkmaster Flex?
Screw all day. Word. All day.
You ever did any chopped up and screwed?
No, I've dabbled in it.
Right.
But like I just they ended up being too long. So
because it's slow in the music, man. Yeah, that's like, wild.
I did one song and ended up like making the song way longer than it needed to be.
So. That's crazy.
But it's something I would like to, you know.
Yeah. I bet it sounded pretty hard, though.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah. He said it stretched it out a long
time. Yeah. Motherfucker was like that. 7 minutes.
Like the old school Sam Cooke songs. That's wild, man. So, DJ Who Kid or Don Cannon?
I'm going to go with Who Kid.
Word.
Who Kid.
Word. I can't argue with that. I like DJ Who Kid.
Yeah.
All the G Unit mixtapes and all that. That's like, what I'm familiar with.
That's that like the first G Unit CD. That's the first CD I ever owned.
Hard.
Like on my own. That's the first CD I ever owned.
Which one?
The Beg for Mercy.
The album.
Mm-hmm.
That was disgusting. Yeah, that was crazy. I listen to that all the time. Know every joint. Yeah. Okay, so I got Lil Wayne, No Ceilings. or 50 Cent is the future?
I'm
both mixtapes.
I'm going to go with No Ceilings.
Word. Okay. Yeah, you a Toon Chief guy.
I mean, no, don't get me wrong. I'm a 50 Cent guy, too, but...
Most definitely.
I played the fuck out of that No Ceilings.
Yeah.
Like, Fifty is actually one of my favorite artists of all time.
Mine, too. I love 50.
Yeah.
Definitely. And I guess he kind of started the mixtape thing going, but
Wayne took off.
He took it to a different level.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's hard. So, what's like the biggest, like most memorable, you ever DJ an event?
No, I've had people contact me about DJing events. It's just something I don't really, care to do.
Maybe in the near future or something.
Maybe, but I mean, I got to get the equipment for it and all
right,
that.
Right. There's a lot comes to it. Yeah.
Yeah, and I kind of prefer just staying behind the scenes. Yeah.
It's not your lane, so yeah.
Yeah.
I got you. You definitely tearing up the mixtape lane is your lane.
Yeah.
Definitely. So that's hard, man. I was just out of my own curiosity, you know what I mean? So, Stomp the Yard or Hustle and Flow?
Hustle and Flow all day. I have a poster of Hustle and Flow in my living room.
Words. Yeah. I didn't know that either. I didn't know that. That's just crazy that that happened. But, okay, Hustle and Flow.
Ask me about The Godfather next. What? I got a poster of that too.
Do you? Yeah. Okay, oh, that's a classic. You already know that.
Yeah.
Godfather. Okay, so DJ Drama or DJ Clue?
Drama.
Yeah, I figured I'd do that one. So I like DJ Clue too though. Yeah. So let me ask you this. So some ups and downs along the way, within your journey of life. Could you tell me a few situations?
Really just, losing jobs.
Okay.
Finding out who really got your back whenever you need them.
Word.
None of that. I mean, just financial.
Life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot, there's going to be a lot of ups and downs in life. But
most definitely.
Everything happens for a reason.
Yeah.
And,
it's how you react to it.
Yeah, the shortcomings I've gone through has just, made me a stronger person.
It is. It develops you to who you are today.
Yep.
So, all it does is make a great story.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the bounce back is everything. Everything that you went through. You're learning as you go. Like, okay, I'm going to do it this way. Yeah. So, all right, moving forward with this. With all them records that was coming to your email, how many emails do you have? Ask DJ Slick the same question.
You have
just one email?
I have two.
Okay.
Two.
At least two?
Yeah. Because
with all the joints that was coming through. But do you got, not just through email, but do you have, what you call it, where you can send, is it WeTransfer?
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever use that?
Yeah, that's what I usually use.
We may have used that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To transfer projects whenever I'm done.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people use Dropbox. I don't really care for Dropbox.
Me either. I rather retransfer. It seems more easy accessible.
Yeah, just zip it up, send it.
Yeah, because you got some records flying through there.
Yeah,
a lot of records. I was wondering that. So, okay. With chicken wings, do you prefer drums or flats?
Flats.
Flats, guy.
Yes, sir.
I'm catching a lot of flats people here lately. Yeah.
That's just less work.
Easy accessible.
Yeah.
The thing just comes out. Okay, that's nice. That's nice. Logic or Pro Tools?
I'm gonna go with Pro Tools.
Right. I probably would too. Yeah. Is there a specific reason behind it? Plugins?
Not necessarily. It's just better
it's two or three different versions of Pro Tools.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just prefer the interface of it.
Oh, the interface?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, nice. Shout out to Pro Tools gang. You already know. So, like I was getting into earlier, do you still hold relationships with artists that you've done mixes with or business with?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A lot of them, huh?
Yeah.
Fair share of people.
Quite a few.
Yeah. Shout out to all them, man.
I went to Houston. That was 4 years ago now that I think about it.
Time flies.
Time is flying.
It really
But
is.
yeah, I went with a couple artists. I went with Ceno Fresh and Rodan Locke.
Word.
And we linked up with some people in Detroit down there.
Word, word, word. Most definitely. That's nice. That's nice. So, I figure, yeah, because the catalog is just crazy out there. You're building a nice portfolio and just adding on to it. You know what I mean?
I mean, that's just, you know, that's what it's all about, networking.
How many joints you think you've done so far? Taking a wild guess.
I counted them one time, but that was a while ago. I'd say probably close to 150.
Were?
I think so, yeah.
150 projects. And counting. That's nice. 150. Y'all catch up. That's hard. And it's still to be continued. Yeah. Like, this is still going.
I don't even know how many I dropped, like, my first year. Because, like you said earlier, I was dropping back to back to back to back.
Yeah.
That's literally all I would do was mix.
Definitely.
Get home from work, mix.
Man, you was putting that work in. Salute to you, man. So, that's nice, man. So, you're a wrestling man?
Yes, sir.
WCW or WWF?
WWF.
I knew it.
All day.
I knew that. Remember the Wolfpack?
Yep.
Yeah. Is there a specific reason why you rolled with them?
That's just what I grew up watching.
Mm-hmm.
I'm hip to WCW, but yeah. I just...
The Rock, Kevin Nash, Stone Cold.
Yeah. Like
Bill Goldberg. Well, he was in both, wasn't
he?
He went from WCW to WWF, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember that.
And that's like the Attitude Era.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Degeneration X.
Yeah.
New World Order. Yeah. Okay. I can't argue with that one, though.
There's so many classic wrestlers that came out of WWF.
Yeah. Like the Big Dogs.
Yeah.
Shawn Michaels. Razor Ramon.
Triple H.
Triple H, yeah. I've been to a WrestleMania before. It was in Atlanta. Yeah. Oh,
that's dope.
Yeah, it was the one in
Atlanta. That's something I've always wanted to do.
It was pretty fun. Definitely. It was a nice experience. I think Pee Wee Herman was there. Snoop Dogg and Snooki. And who else? Is it Sierra? One of those singers. I forget which one. Yeah, it was pretty fun.
Snoop's been to a couple of WrestleManias. He was at last year's.
Yeah, he has.
Like a special guest. He actually had his own title.
Word. Oh, yeah, he getting that check. He had his own title. I didn't know that either. Yeah. He getting that wrestling bag. Snoop getting all kind of checks.
Man, I'm trying to be like him.
So, Dad, that's hard, man. Moving forward with this, I got to pop you with this question. Your top five or your top seven artists of all time?
Okay.
I'll start with five, but if you got seven.
All right. Top five.
Petty question.
In no particular order.
No particular order.
Eminem.
Word.
Just because he's one of the first artists that got me into rap.
Shout out to Slim Shady.
It was him and Afro Man.
Afro Man.
My mom had that CD.
Yeah, Afro Man. Yeah, that one single that everybody was listening to. Word.
M.
Shout out to M, the wordplay magician.
50.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're starting off right.
Let's see. M, 50, Wayne, of course.
It's a nice three.
We're going dead or alive or just all time?
Any artist.
Your groups ever. Count?
You can throw groups in there.
Wu-Tang.
They incorporated one of my later on questions, but yeah.
Where we at now?
That's four. That's four. That's
okay.
Four.
I'll
let you slide.
How am I forgetting that? Kid Cudi. All time.
Were? Okay.
Yeah.
I need to dive more in.
Yeah, he got me through a lot, like my teenage years.
Word.
Yeah.
What kind of music does Kid Cudi make? Is it more like, is it?
It's kind of different, like every project, really. Like he evolves his sound a lot. Like
he's real lyrical, or has he got a more of a melody driven sound?
Or I'd say it's more melody. His like more recent stuff is
okay. Word.
Like he actually came out with a rock album.
Did he?
Yeah.
Hmm.
It's pretty good. I mean, it's different for sure.
I seen him in it was like the latest house party movie they came out with. He was in it.
Oh, he was in it?
Yeah. Him and LeBron James. Okay, so we have four, I think, because I let you ride with a group.
Okay,
No.
okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm trying to like think without looking at my phone. Because I got so many artists on there.
Ah, there's so many. If
Yeah.
you do that, you'll
Yeah, I
be
feel like that's kind of
scatterbrained.
cheating. Who do I listen to the most? Like, I actually thought about this. I've been thinking about this
It's like
all
making, yeah,
week.
it's like making a song list. Remember, we
Yeah.
used to like burn CDs, and like when it's time to make the CD, you can't think of them. But before you want to make the CD, you think of all these different songs.
Yeah. I'm gonna go with T.I.
Word,
Yeah.
tip. Word. Can't argue with that one. That's a good one. Tip. What's your favorite tip album?
King.
The
Not
King.
well, either between King or trap music.
Okay. One of his earlier albums.
Yeah.
Word. Okay, nice. You ever go to Buttermilk down there in Barstown?
Yeah.
Do you?
Yeah, I've been a couple times.
Man, I like the Buttermilk Festival.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on in that town.
A lot.
It's thick out there. It's like a part of the culture in Barstown.
Yep. Yeah,
Every year.
that's what we're known for, really.
Yeah.
Buttermilk and Bourbon Festival.
Yeah, and the Bourbon Festival. I
Because
was
we
gonna
got
ask you about that too.
a lot of distilleries.
Yes, most definitely. Shout out to the organizers of all that,
Too
man.
many distilleries, really. Like,
Man. I wonder how many of those has been thrown. How long they been doing that, you think? Since the 80s or something? Been that long?
the Bourbon Festival or
Yeah.
Buttermilk? I'm not sure, really.
That's a good question, huh?
Yeah, because I have no clue. Like, I probably
I mean, it's
like
major.
since the 90s, like
Yeah,
I'd
at least
say,
the 90s.
yeah.
I mean, it's been major for it's been for a while. Man, I like that. I like the culture of that. So moving forward with this, and plus that's what I've stuck out to me about bar sounds. There's a lot of unsolved mysteries down there. That's just
Yeah.
random thought about when I'm thinking. That's a lot of unsolved, yeah, stuff going on down
And like
there.
it all happened in, a sh short period of time too. That's what's crazy
Word.
about it.
Yeah.
But like a lot of people think it's all connected. Me personally, I don't know.
Right, we
I
don't know
ain't got nothing
nothing.
to
Yeah. That's neither here or there. We don't
Yeah.
know any no details.
It's just it's crazy how it blew
It
up though. Like there's a
is.
documentary on Peacock about it.
Yeah. I'm not gonna say the name, but
Yeah.
the girl that yeah. I realized that about B Town. I like downtown Barstown too. It's like
Yeah.
real classy. It's got a lot of little
Yeah, it's
shops and
got a lot down
stuff.
there. Like
It does.
I've actually never even been to most of
Word.
them.
Yeah, I just drive through there when I go through.
Yeah.
So, moving forward with this. All right, you're stranded on the desert island, right? What five music projects would you like to spend your time with while you're on that island?
Get Rich or Die Trying.
That's a classic. That's a good way to start it.
Enter the 36 Chambers.
Okay. Word.
Probably Carter 2.
That's a good one. Carter two.
Yes, sir.
I like that because most people mention the Carter three or four.
Yeah, Carter 2 is probably my favorite
I
one.
like the Carter two. The beats on that was
The
nice too.
Chronic.
The production. Word. First
And
Chronic, Dr. Dre.
yeah.
Okay.
And let's
That's
go with
a five right there.
that's hard, dog. Like
It's always
I
difficult.
listen to
It's
so
a petty
much
question.
music.
It's a petty question for real if you think about
I've tried to prepare myself for questions like these too.
it. It makes you think.
Yeah. Let's go with
For the culture. It
Damn.
definitely takes your time.
Yeah.
You need that contemplation time so you can make the right decision.
Because I mean, I'm going to be listening to this for a long time,
Yo,
so.
I change my when it comes to the list and stuff, I change mine all
Yeah, like,
the time.
let's go with, Let's go with Trap or Die. Jeezy.
That's a good one. That's a nice one.
Was that five?
Yeah, okay, that's five. Cool. That's a nice solid five. I'm glad you pulled it out of yourself, two out of five. Yeah, that's nice. So your favorite restaurant, would you rather have a home-cooked meal or do you got a favorite restaurant?
I'd much rather have a home-cooked meal.
Most definitely.
Because I hate cooking.
Right.
So I'd be eating out a lot.
He said, I hate cooking. Yeah.
That DoorDash is...
hey, they get busy.
Man.
Yeah. They get you sometimes, too.
Oh, every time.
I forgot your sweet tea. Like, what?
Yeah.
How you forget my drink?
If you're getting sauces, straws, silverware.
Like, dang, I forgot the whole meal.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll be right back.
They don't even be dropping off the right place sometimes.
Right.
Like, I live in an apartment complex.
Mm-hmm.
They done dropped the shit off across the street in a house.
Somebody done got your food and they're watching Netflix eating.
Yeah, they done did that with
thank you, smashing
grocery delivery, too.
Oh, yeah. I went through that, too.
Somebody done got me one time.
I went through it with that, man. Because I did it for a while until it started going bad.
Yeah.
Like, they were sending me bad grapes and stuff like that. I'm like, yo, y'all pick these grapes out? Yo, like, there's no way. They must have ran them grapes over before they got it. Do you mess with any of the other food services? Like, you know, is it food hub or what's it called?
There's Grubhub.
Grubhub, yeah.
when I'm in Louisville, yeah.
You try those too?
Yeah.
Where?
Uber Eats,
that's another one.
Yeah. I mostly just stick with DoorDash.
Yeah, because I only did DoorDash.
Yeah, that's just what we got, so.
It's hard. Sometimes it's convenient sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's expensive, though.
Definitely. So, definitely when it comes to you mixing, I love the personality that you mix with, you know what I mean? Because you got the nice drops, you know what I mean? It's right on timing. Like, timing's important when you're throwing them plugins and them drops in, you know what I mean? And I just want to admire that. I want to big up that, you know
Appreciate
what I mean?
It.
You got any of your favorite plugins or drops that you know right off the top?
There's so many.
Yeah, there's a lot.
I got some drops from HotBoy Turk.
Word.
Yeah.
That's hard. Yeah. Shout out to Young Turk, man. HotBoy, the original HotBoy.
He sent that fast, too.
Word. Yeah, I remember that one, too.
Like, he shouted me on Twitter and everything. It was weird. It was all random. Like,
he's cool, man.
So, you know, after he did that, I emailed him. Mm-hmm. He sent me some drops in, like, 15 minutes.
I remember that drop.
Yeah.
Shout out to Cash Money and Turk.
Yeah, Turk. I got a drop from one of Future's DJs, DJ Esco.
Okay. Shout out to Esco. That's a hard one. Yeah.
Let's see.
Both of them. There's two hard drops right there.
Yeah. There's a drop. My boy Rich Don Dada did.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's another drop. The people swear it's Young Dolph, but it's not. It's my boy Hitman Shawty.
Word.
Yeah.
That's hard. And speaking of Dolph, I seen that where he, the other day, where he had just went to get that cookie from the cookie place.
Mm-hmm.
It was crazy. But yeah, shout out to them. Them some hard drops.
Yeah, I got a lot of drops.
Yeah.
But I try to like, I'll listen to the song before I place anything.
Mm-hmm.
And if I have a drop that kind of fits the lyrics, I'll try to plug it in there.
Mm-hmm. That's smart.
And I'll just kind of go from that.
Right, right. That way you're going out the vibe of what's going on. Yeah. You ain't just throwing things everywhere. Pause. So nice, man. So, all right, moving forward. I got a few more questions with this. Tim's or Chuck Taylor's?
I'm gonna go with Chuck's just because. I mean, I'm not gonna say they're easier to put on because they're a motherfucker to put on.
Nah, but I'm a Chuck face.
Yeah. And Tim's are just all chunky and shit, so they're heavy.
Yeah, they just they fit for what it is.
Yeah,
snow and up north. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I can't argue with that. I figured like that was a good one. I got both, but I probably Tim's. But okay, so. The movie Juice or 8 Mile?
8 Mile.
Word.
Yeah.
Classic. It's like 8 Mile is just like, it's one of those movies you can watch again. You know what I mean?
I've seen the movie countless times.
Yes, like, most definitely.
I can damn near recite it.
Mm-hmm. Two classics right there. Yeah. 3-6 Mafia or Wu-Tang?
Wu-Tang. That's hard.
Yeah,
that's hard. But,
that's
the question. But I'm going to go with Wu-Tang, though.
Yeah, because you're a Wu guy, though.
Yeah.
But you team Wu.
Yeah.
But I thought that was a good one.
3-6 Mafia, though.
Yeah, you sticking with it?
Yeah.
Is there a reason behind it?
I just their style, man.
Yeah.
Like, not there's
They're rappers, rapper too.
yeah,
They rap a lot
each
more.
member has their own specific style.
Most definitely. Yeah.
Like you never know what you're gonna get. I
Yeah.
mean, with 3 6, I mean, it's I'm not gonna say it's repetitive, but it's, you know, it's kind of the same sound, really.
Man, I can say a
To
lot.
an extent.
Yeah. I can say a
No
lot.
disrespect, but
That's how you feel about it. I
yeah.
respect it. Mortal Kombat or Street Fighter?
Mortal Kombat all day.
That
All
was a
day.
good one too, bro, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I remember playing Mortal Kombat on my friend's Sega. I was like six. So
Man, when I first, yeah.
I've been playing that
A
since.
Sega?
Yeah.
Yeah. I remember the first time I played it, and I was just overwhelmed by the graphics.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like little, I'm looking at it like, yo, he's like ripping his head off
Yeah,
and
all the
stuff. Like,
blood.
yo,
Like, I
this
didn't
is
know
wild.
they could put shit out like
Yeah,
this.
it was different for me
And
when I first
now,
seen it.
yeah, I got that new one, the Mortal Kombat 1,
Yeah, hard.
and the fatalities on that are crazy.
That the one with Goro at the end? Or is that the two? Mortal Kombat 2.
I haven't done the story yet, so.
Yeah.
But Goro, he's a like a cameo character.
Oh, word.
Yeah.
So no, on original, on the was it Goro on the original Mortal Kombat 1? Was he at the end? That's a good question for you. I'm a Street Fighter guy too, though.
Yeah,
That's
I
true.
got that new Street Fighter 2. It's
Hard?
cool. Yeah.
Is it? You got it on Xbox?
Yeah, it was about Xbox.
I'm gonna check that out. Even though I got a PlayStation. Nice. So, Lil Durk or Pop Smoke?
Dirt.
Word. Nice. Like them.
I fuck with Pop Smoke though,
Do you
but
rock with him?
yeah,
Me
but
too.
I'm gonna say Dirt.
Yeah. God bless. Lil Durk got the melodies. Got them Chicago stories too, man.
Yeah.
Just
His like trajectory has been crazy too. Like, or when he had the dreads and shit,
Yes.
and
Yeah. He had a whole like resurrection. Like he
yeah,
went.
his sound has gotten a lot different throughout the years as well.
Most definitely.
I feel like Pop Smoke, he didn't really get enough time to get the shine he deserved, really,
That's a good
because
answer.
yeah,
Yeah.
he was a dope artist.
That's a good point. He didn't really, his career didn't extend like that. Yeah. But I guess for the little time he was here, though, yeah, I guess he made some
Oh
noise.
yeah.
Yeah. And his voice is dope. I like both of them. Word. So, this is a question I often ask. Discipline or motivation? Which one do you think is more important to what you have going on in everyday life?
I'm gonna say discipline just because I have very little, and that's something I need to work on.
Okay.
But in order to have discipline, you have to have motivation at the same time. So
Most definitely. At
I'd
least
say,
you're acknowledging the fact.
yeah.
Yeah.
So I'd say probably motivation would be more important
Word.
because you don't
Okay.
have anything without motivation, really.
Most definitely. Me, yeah. Because, I mean, me personally, I don't have a problem being motivated or inspired. I wake up just ready to, like, I'm just like, oh, I'm up again? I'm
Yeah.
alive again? Like, yo, I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
Let's create, let's build, you know, let's grind. Yeah. So that's a nice answer. That's a nice answer. I gotta ask everybody that when they come up here. So yeah, I gotta pop you with this one. What do you enjoy most about your craft or DJing?
It's gotten me like
Relationships?
yeah, it's got yeah, it's I've gone places and talked to people I never thought I'd talk to
Yeah.
because you know, I'm a DJ. Like,
Right.
it's just, I don't know,
So this took
it's
you to different extreme measures as far as who you've been around, who's brought you around, and
yeah,
yeah.
like it's I never thought I'd be going to DJ Drama Studio to,
Word.
you know, go talk to A&R.
Factual.
Like,
Yeah.
it's just
That's ex
crazy.
nice. Turned into a nice
I
experience.
went to Starlito's engineer's house.
Hard. Shout to them.
Like, and everybody in Nashville's been there.
Lido, yeah.
Like, it's just cool.
That's
And
hard. I know that's how I met you, was through the music. Yeah.
we've known each other for a long time,
Most
really.
definitely. I was thinking about that
I
before you
don't
came up
remember
here.
exactly like Facebook, obviously, but I don't remember exactly when we started talking.
There's no telling. I mean, we had a few mutual people that we know, most definitely. But it was probably something within the music realm, I'm sure of. You know what I mean? It may have been me. I may have said something to you first. Who knows?
Could have. I remember like seeing a music video that you had posted that you had done.
Word.
And I just kind of started, you know, keeping track of you from there.
Yeah. When I was going hard with it. And yeah, I seen most definitely people that I've known, I've seen them acknowledging you too. And that always helps sometimes. Yeah. That's hard. So, top five DJs of all time? Who you got? All
right, let's go with...
I had to ask this.
Drama.
Mm-hmm.
Horrible. Big Rankin.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm digging these lists today.
Don Cannon.
Mm-hmm.
DJ Scream, of course.
Mm-hmm.
We have three or four.
Four.
Okay, so one more. I'm going to go with...
Cannon's a good one, too. Cannon.
Wait, did you say mixtape DJs or DJs in general?
Period. Whatever want, whichever one. It could be...
I can't forget Screw, then.
It could be a DJ Pioneer. It could be anybody. Okay. DJ Screw?
Yeah.
Word.
Because I feel like without DJ Screw, there wouldn't be a whole lot of DJs.
Most definitely. You know? And plus, like, the sound. Like, he's a trendsetter, too, most definitely.
He started his own... wave that transpired all across the world, really.
Yeah, global. It went
all out of his spread out his house. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, you ever watch a documentary on DJ Screw? Yeah, that's a hard one. Yeah, that's nice, man. I like that. I like that list. It's a funny question, and it's petty a little bit. But what's a song that you could go the rest of your life without hearing? You know what I mean?
There's so many. So many.
Like Sweet Home Alabama or something. That's one.
There's a lot of songs that I just really don't like that are really popular.
Mm-hmm.
I can't fucking stand.
Like the ones they force you to hear on the radio?
Yeah.
Like, you keep playing this.
Mostly like ones on TikTok.
The like, TikTok gems?
Yeah, I hate them. I hate them so much.
That's hilarious. And they just keep playing it too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even be knowing the names of them, but.
Because they're short, yeah.
Let's just say all of the popular TikTok songs.
All those little trendy little tunes.
Like, there's.
That's funny.
There's too many of the names.
That's funny. I know exactly what you mean, too, man. And TikTok is brainwashing. Like, you just keep. Scroll, it's crazy.
I haven't been on TikTok for like 3 hours one time.
You waking like, yo.
Yeah.
But it's tricky too because it has like informative stuff on there and then it'd be like a recipe.
Yeah.
Like, yo, this looks good.
Like something I'm never going to make, but it looks good.
Yeah.
Because I know if I try to make it, it's not going to turn out looking like that. I'm going to burn some shit. I'm going to forget something. Like,
it'd be looking good on there too. I mean, I'm quesadillas and everything. Well, we've done a few off there. That's hard. So, what's one thing that you feel you can't leave this earth without accomplishing?
That's
a big question.
I'm gonna say, without making sure my family's straight.
Yeah. Yeah. Protecting the fam, making sure they're good.
Because I mean, that's what it's all about at the end of the day.
Most definitely.
So.
That's what we do it for.
You know, just make sure, you know, not even just financially, like just making sure they're good all the way around.
Spiritually?
Yeah.
And then and the right peace, peace of mind and everything.
That's health. That's something I want to work towards as well. Helping, you know.
For the long-term goal.
Yeah.
Longevity.
Like, you know, build their faith more.
Yeah. That's a nice one, man.
That's what I'm working on myself. So,
you got the juice, though. DJ Juice, man, in the building, man. You got any shout-outs?
Shout-out everybody, you know, that supported me throughout the years.
Mm-hmm.
Shout-out my boy Josh for having me.
Had to. Let's get the business. Yeah.
He
deserve it, man. He put that work in.
That's about it, really. I mean,
Word.
if you fuck with me, I appreciate you. If you don't, I still appreciate you.
Yeah, we ain't gonna worry about them.
Cause,
There's a lot of people that do rock with you, man.
yeah,
And I want to bring you up here to show you that love, man, because you are loved and appreciated.
it's
You know
much
what I mean?
appreciated, bro. I'm glad you had me up here.
Most definitely, man. You got any upcoming projects or events or anything?
Not that I can think of off the top of my head. I got a project with Seven coming.
Word.
I got a project with my homie Q coming. I'm gonna probably start doing the Spotify playlists.
Get those slots popping again.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
Yeah.
eventually branch out to do more things.
And go ahead and book them, man. Go ahead and book DJ Juice, man, for your slots, all that Spotify playlist, whatever you got. He got it in the bag for you,
Yeah,
man.
whatever you need.
He's gonna cook you up a nice package.
And you ain't gonna get taxed either.
Most definitely. It's gonna be a nice ticket.
Yep.
But you gotta have the bag right though, so come correct. Believe that.
Yeah.
And we rocking like this, man. Let's get the business.
Let's get the business.
Yo, 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 let's get the business.